Hey guys, and welcome back to Skyrim Special Edition. We are nearly at the end of the week, guys. We're getting super close to release date. I'm sure you guys are super excited. I think little Darcy Parsi I think he's super excited too. You're quite relaxed. You're quite relaxed on my knee, aren't you? I thought I would put plaits in my hair so I could look super Nordic for you guys today as we play some more Skyrim. So in the last episode, we found Esbern in the Ratway in Riften. Esbern is one of the other surviving members of the Blades, who are basically like the dragon slayers of Skyrim. They're pretty cool. And we are now going to bring him back to Delphine, who's kind of like the head dragon slayer. We've got to figure out a way to stop Alduin raising more dragons into Skyrim. So we've got a pretty exciting episode ahead of us. Darcy, as much as I love you chilling out on my knee here, I don't think you're going to be able to be here for a while and playing. So let's just pop you. You can chill out on my desk if you want. You can chill out here. What do you want to do, Bubba? You look like a cat that could like survive in Skyrim, like so fluffy. So guys, let's begin episode 4 of Skyrim Special Edition. So here's how we left things. Esbern is gone, he's buzzed off. Oh no, he's there, he's waiting for us. But do you remember, guys, that we got an awesome doggy? This is gonna be what? Esbern's getting attacked. I've just got my fists out. Wait, I thought we got a better bow than that, you know, guys. I thought we got a better bow. Let's have a look. Yes, we've got an orcish bow now, which is definitely going to do at least a little bit more damage. So let's favorite that. Let's defavorite that. And also, I quite like using this new, like, massive battle axe if I'm just like, forget it, we're going to go in super hard. So let's also keep that. So let's go with our doggy, Esbern. This beautiful, beautiful flame Atronach. Is that spelled Atronach? Atronach. Flame Atronach. Who? I absolutely love their design. Like, how freaking cool looking are those? And also, of course, Ulfgird. So, guys, we are back in Riverwood and we've escorted little Esbern and Doggy and Ulfgird, the whole gang! We're heading back to. Oh my gosh, this lady's name. It doesn't. Delphine. That's it. We're heading back to her. So we can show that we managed to rescue him from the little hole that he'd locked himself in. With like 17,000 locks as well. Like, he was definitely paranoid. I think all the surviving Blades are paranoid. Here we go, Delphine. Do you not recognize him?
What is it?
He's here! How do you not see him? Are they going to have some sort of embrace? Is Ulfgird going to get in the way?
Delphine.
I want to watch. There we go.
It's been a long time.
Stop.
It's good to see you too, Esbern.
Aww.
It's been too long, old friend. Too long.
Aww. A nice little music playing as well.
You made it safe and sound. Good.
Of course I did, guys.
Come on,
I'm the dragon
place
born.
We can talk.
Awesome.
Orknar, hold down the bar for a minute, will you?
Yes.
Well, that was nice. Thanks, Bard, for the very, very kind of appropriate music, I would say. Okay, time to go in our secret little area. Come on, gang. Come on, dog. You're coming to you. You can come too. Come on, dog. In you come. Come on. We're going down our little secret way. Oh, hey, Ulfgird.
I'm still here.
Yeah, you wait here.
Go on ahead. I'll stand guard.
Sure you will. Let's just leave you outside.
Come, let me show you.
Show us what? What is this?
It's right here. Skyhaven.
This is the book that he's just given us. Look! It's all the burial sites for the Dragonborn. The dragons. Check that out. Look, it's super long as well. This is what I really like about Skyrim. Like, so many of the books are so detailed. If you have the time to read them, they'll explain a lot of the lore.
Camps in the Reach during their conquest of Skyrim.
Do you know what he's talking about?
I mean, I was kind of reading the book.
This
so.
Is where they built Alduin's Wall, to set down in stone all their accumulated dragon lore.
Alduin's
the hedge
Wall.
Against the forgetfulness of centuries. Despite the far
reaching
fame,
I've put on
extra
subtitles,
Wall
guys.
At the time, one of the wonders of the ancient world, its location was lost.
So we have to find Alduin's Wall.
What are you getting at?
You don't mean to say you haven't heard of Alduin's Wall? Either of you?
Let's pretend we haven't.
Don't ask me.
What's Alduin's Wall and what does it have to do with stopping the dragons?
Alduin's Wall was where the ancient blades recorded all they knew of Alduin and his return. Part history, part prophecy. His location has been lost for centuries. But I have found it again. Not lost, you see, just forgotten.
So this guy's like a proper keen on dragons. Archives. He's done so much research.
I was only able to save a few scraps.
So we need to find
Alduin's Wall.
So you think Alduin's
Wall will tell us how to defeat Alduin?
Well, yes. But there's no guarantee, of course.
It's better than nothing.
Skyhaven Temple it is, then. I knew you'd have something for us, Ezrin.
Thanks,
I know
Esper.
The area of the reach that Ezrin's talking about, near what's now known as Karth's Fire, in the Karth River Canyon.
Okay.
We can meet you there, or all travel together. Your call.
Well, I feel like you guys are slow, so we'll
Your
meet
call.
You guys there.
It might be safer to travel separately. Attract less attention that way. Don't worry, I'll get Ezrin there in one piece. We'll wait for you near Karth's Fire. Good luck.
Okay, we'll see you guys soon. So the Skyhaven Temple is literally the, home of the Blades. It's kind of like their awesome base of operations, which is super cool because it means that now, hopefully, we're going to get to go there and check it out. So in the meantime, there's a lot of stuff here that I can use for... Oh, that's empty. Let's grab all this. Grab. That I can use to level up. So I'm going to quickly do lots of leveling up now. Disenchant what I can. You can also eat items to find out what their effects are, but obviously if it's got a bad effect, then you get that bad effect, but it does increase your alchemy skills doing that as well. So there we go, we've increased it to level 18, and it's just enough to help us level up. So, let's level up. Again, I'm not going to focus on stamina, because if I'm going to focus on doing the mage kind of route, then there's no point wasting it on stamina. So let's give ourselves a little bit more magicka. I think having healing spells that cure 50% more is going to be super useful at the moment. So that's what we're going to take for now. There is a regeneration perk upgrade, I believe. That means whenever you heal, you also heal your... Oh, look at this map. You also heal your stamina, which is obviously super useful. Map of dragon burials. Let's definitely take that. Because it means that you can constantly... I suppose Uthgard can come along.
We going?
You can just run, but then keep healing the whole time, and it will keep boosting your stamina. So I think we've probably got a good walk ahead of us. Luckily, it's a very nice day. Nice day for doing some walks. Let's see where we've got to head to. So, world map, please. Oh, wow. So, it's actually super, super northeast, southwest. There's a lot to do. Never eat shredded wheat. Not your elephant squirt water. It's quite near Markarth. So, it's fully west of the map. So, as far as we've ever gone is Rorikstead. So, we've got a good walk ahead of us. Markarth is an interesting one because on 360, I got stuck on a glitch where the guards would just attack me no matter what I did. Like, every time I entered Markarth, they'd just kill me to death. Every time. And there was nothing I could do. I could never surrender to them. And it basically meant that I couldn't ever visit Markarth. So I have some bad vibes towards that place. But we never know. We may end up heading there soon. But for now, let's head to Karth Spire and gain entrance to the Skyhaven Temple. Mm-hmm. So one thing that you guys recommended in the comments is you can use this horse and carriage to get to new holds that you've not been to for the first time. It's pretty cheap to use. And it's almost like a version of fast traveling, but to places you may not have been before. I knew you could do this, but I so rarely use these. It just doesn't really click in my mind to do them. If I'm playing on PC, and I'm playing like my own like story, I never ever fast travel. I get a horse or I walk everywhere. I think it's a more immersive way to do it because in real life you can't just click your fingers and get somewhere. But also you will discover so many places that you would have never discovered if you were just fast traveling everywhere. So when the game releases on Friday, honest to God, steal or buy a horse and or go on foot and do that because you will find so much stuff. However, I'm obviously trying to get through this storyline for you guys before Skyrim releases. So we are going
to
use
a horse and traveler.
Horse and carriage. And of course, Markarth was the closest place. So that's just made me think it might have been Morthal that I had the glitch at. It was one of those two places. But anyway, we need to head to Markarth because it's the closest place.
Climb back and we'll be off.
And we're going to use this, so thank you, commenter, who reminded me that we can do this. Let's get in the back of the carriage.
Ever been to Markarth?
Some say it was built by the dwarves.
There we go. Word of it. And you get a little factoid about the place that you're going to. Extra, extra handy. Can you see Evie in the background with her little pants on? Where she's over there. she's got little pants on because she may have entered her first season. It was this place. It definitely was Markarth that I got trapped in. Couldn't go there. Could not go there. Very frustrating. Ooh, look. Brown and white horse. We really want one, but there's no one to buy one from. We're going to have to steal one. But that could give us a bounty that means we can never come back here again. You know what? Guys, we're going to wait. We're going to do the right thing and we're going to wait. So yeah, Little Evie Beavie is on season. If you've never had a girl dog before, it means you have to put little pantaloons on them.
A war dog is good company and good protection.
A war dog? Wait, he's got a dog too. Oh, look. Vigilance. That's his dog. But we've got our nice stray dog. We're going to keep that one. Your dog is very nice, sir. But
you need a reliable horse in the reach.
I need to buy a horse, please.
Got one all saddled and ready to go.
I will give you this.
Sounds fair. She's yours. Like I said.
What was I saying? So yeah, you have... No! No, no! I just bought that. I just bought it. Get off the horse. No!
Order of the yard. Stop right there.
Get off the horse, you gobshite. No! Oh my gosh, I thought it was my horse. We're gonna have to do that again. I don't want to get a bounty on that place in case that glitch still exists. So, we're gonna gallop our way now to go meet the Blades squad. And I like this black and white horse. There's some really cool mods that you can get for the full game, which basically gives your horse like full armor. And I think the armor is kind of unique to each hold. So, depending on which holds... Yeah, Elphic Strongplug. So depending on which holds armor you like the best, you'll just get the horse from that one. And it's basically very, very cool. There's also mods for different dogs, different like animal companions that you can get. I think you can get one that changes the default dog to be a husky. So super cool. I think maybe little changes like that, like making the main dogs huskies because the husky model already exists. That feels like the kind of mod that they may be able to bring to the game. So that's pretty cool. Also, look how like moldy and misty and horrible this place looks. It's not very nice in the west of Skyrim. What's that noise? Oh, it's a bit spooky around here, actually. A little bit spooky, but never mind. Let's keep galloping and let's get to the Skyhaven Temple. Oh my gosh, a dragon! A dragon up ahead! Oh my gosh, it's fighting other people. Okay, horse. We do not want you to get hurt. But we have to save these people from the dragon. Get back, dragon. It's a blood dragon. Horse, no! Horse, don't you try and get involved in this. This is not your battle. Delphine is nearby. Oh my gosh, look, it's those guys. They're here. They're fighting this dragon with us. So, as a high elf, I actually have something called Highborn, which I can activate once a day, which lets me regenerate my magic. I think it's like 50% faster or 100% faster. Either way, it's super useful. I'm going to see if it lets me activate it now. Yes, it has done. So, our mage powers should be pretty sick at the moment. Where's my horse gone? It's over there. Protect the horse at all costs. Oh my gosh, I love it when it plays the epic music when you're fighting a dragon. This dragon's not very landy.
Who's? Run!
Oh gosh, it's coming at me! It's coming at me! No! No! Why it always bites my head? It always bites my head. Oh, I must taste so freaking good, man. Like crispy chicken. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh, somehow we've run into the Forsworn. So the Forsworn are like almost like a tribal sort of people. They actually war with the Nords. Oh my gosh, there's a dragon fighting us at the same time. And they actually are really like... they hang around with wizards and Hargravens and all kinds of horrible things. So they're not very nice people at all. Hey, stray dog. Not nice folk. Not ideal to be fighting when you've also got a dragon fighting you. As you can probably tell. So that's the Hargraven. Oh god, they're so ugly. Oh, they are like horrible witchy things. And I think they basically do a spell for the plus one where they remove their hearts. And give them like a briar heart thing to make them even stronger. Oh my gosh, I'm getting attacked at all angles here. I don't know if I'm going to be able to do this. Wait, is Hermit's going in here? Oh man, maybe I could avoid all this entirely. I didn't realize I could do that. I hope my horse has survived. That would be really bad. I only just got the little horsey. So we actually have to go down here into the Karth Spire. Esbern's there. Is Doggy there? Oh my gosh, where's Ilfgar? Have Ilfgar and Doggy not survived? Oh my gosh, the Frost One here too. Back off, Frost One. No! Oh my gosh, thank gosh for those guys. There we go. That's one of those Briar Hearts I was talking about. Oh, they've just killed it, they've just killed it. I actually think the Force One armor is really cool, but it's not really suitable for a mage. I'm a bit worried that neither Dog nor Earthgird have come through with me. That's pretty worrying. So that's how the Force One armor looks. Pretty cool, pretty cool. But unfortunately, not very helpful for us at all. So let's check out this Briar Heart. Can you see? Oh yeah, you can see. He's got an exposed heart. And we can actually take the Briar Heart from him. So here we are in the Karth Spire.
These pillars must have something to do with it.
And there's a little trick for us to learn.
Activate symbols.
Activate pillar. Oh, okay.
King and warrior. And of course the symbol for dragonborn. That's the one that appears to have a sort of arrow shape pointing downward.
Okay, so that one's dragonborn. So it has to... is there anything around that can help us?
Given that Skyhaven Temple sealed against the return of the dragonborn. I will try turning all the pillars.
So you've made them all dragonborn.
Whatever you did.
Ooh! There we go. Oh gosh, they just went up a little secret passage where I didn't even see that.
Wait.
Why are you stopping?
We should be careful here.
That's fiery, isn't it?
Esbern's right. Look like pressure plates.
Oh, so the dragonborn ones don't hurt. Okay, so we always need to step on dragonborn. Dragonborn. Dragonborn.
Cross once it's safe.
Dragonborn, dragonborn, dragonborn. There we go.
Let's move.
Hey. Oh, we put the next one down as well. This is pretty cool. I like this. This is fun. I actually can do the puzzles. Not as hard as the ones in Rise of Tomb Raider. Oh my gosh, I sucked so badly at those. What is this? A chest. Look, orcish arrows, gold, a little crown, leather armor of conjuring. I shall take them all. Come on, slowpokes.
Here's the blood seal. Another of the lost Akaviri arts. No doubt it's triggered by, well,
blood. What?
Your blood, dragonborn.
You have to like...
Look here. You see how the ancient blades revered me?
So I have to bleed and activate the seal. Right, okay, can I just talk about this? Why does this always happen on films? If you had to bleed, you'd cut yourself like here. Or like here. Why would you do it on the hand that has to hold weapons? That's so dumb. That always vexes me. Ooh, look. The head has gone backwards. Into the Skyhaven Temple! But yeah, if you agree with that whole hand slashing thing, please let me know in the comments. Make sure I'm not going mad. I 100% think that if I ever had to cut myself, I would not do it at that very sensitive, quite thick-skinned, and also needing to be useful area of my body. I just wouldn't. So, do you reckon that this is Alduin's wall, perhaps? This place is pretty cool, but it needs some sprucing up. Needs some cleaning down, like the chairs are all facing the wrong way. What's through here? A chest? Hello? Guys, we've got it! We've got the Blade's armor. How freaking cool is the Blade's armor? Should we just put it all on? So here is how the Blade's armor looked. That's what I was wearing in my last thumbnail. How freaking cool does that armor look? I actually think in my thumbnail I had a slightly tweaked modded version of it. You know something else I think they've sorted out? They've sorted out the hair when you're wearing a helmet. Oh my gosh, I swear to God, in original 360 Skyrim, if you were a girl with long hair, or a guy, and you put your helmet on, you lost the hair when you put the helmet on. But look at it, it's there. And there is the awesome Blade's armor. Oh, looks so cool. So cool. Should we equip our weapons as well? There we go. And the Blade's shield. So this is what you would go to fight dragons with. Pa-pow, pow, pow, pow. So here's Alduin's wall, guys.
Look, here is Alduin. This panel goes back to the beginning of time. And Alduin and the dragon cult ruled over Skyrim.
So that's Alduin.
Here, the human
pretty
is
scary.
With them.
We don't like him.
The legendary dragon. Alduin's defeat is the centerpiece.
So that's
see,
Alduin's
here
defeat.
He is fallen from the sky. The Nord Tongs, masters of the voice, are arrayed against him.
So does it show how they
look?
Isn't that
masters one? Of the voice? That looks like the Greybeards.
Patience, my dear. The Akaviri were not a straightforward people. Everything is couched in allegory and mythic symbolism. Yes, yes. This here, coming from the mouths of the Nord heroes, this is the Akaviri symbol for shout. But there's no way to know what shout is meant.
You mean they used a shout to defeat Alduin? You're sure?
Hmm? Oh, yes. Presumably something rather specific to dragons.
So, we need to
or
learn a
Alduin
special
himself.
Shout to
remember,
defeat Alduin.
This is where they recorded all the new of Alduin.
Have you ever heard of such a thing? A shout that can knock a dragon out of the sky?
I don't have that one yet, but the Greybeards might know.
I was hoping to avoid having to involve them in this.
She's meant to be holding a torch.
No
instead,
choice.
She looks like, do you know? She's shaking a fist at me. Why don't you like Greybeards?
If they had their way, you do nothing but sit up on their mountain with them and talk to the sky or whatever it is they do.
To be fair,
the
Greybeards
are so afraid of power that they won't use it. Think
about
it. Have they tried to stop the civil war or done anything about Alduin? No. And they're afraid of you, of your power.
They didn't seem that afraid when I shouted in their face.
Think of Tiber Septim. Do you think he'd have founded the Empire if he'd listened to the Greybeards? You're Dragonborn, and you're the only one who can stop Alduin. Don't forget it.
Okay, but I better go and find out.
Good thing
they've
already let you into
the shell. I also think I've got horn to give them as well.
Not likely they'd help Esbern or me if we came calling. We'll look around Skyhaven Temple and see what else the old Blades might have left for us.
Sounds
like a
plan.
It's a better hideout than I could have hoped for.
I hope it's all pimped out
Talos
when I get back.
Guard you.
Thank you. Okay, let's head back to the Greybeards. See if they know anything of this mysterious shout that we need to use. So guys, we're back at High Hrothgar. I think we should probably change out of this kick-ass armor because they're definitely going to know something's wrong if we're wearing this. So there's no reason why we can't at least keep the little booties on though, you know? Just like a little something-something. And we'll keep the gauntlets on too. So we've got back to our major armor, but we're keeping just a little something in the blades just to let them know they're close to our heart. And if you've noticed, I only have Horsey. Horsey has survived, but Urgerd and the dog are both dead. She's not great, so we're gonna need to get another companion. So let's try and find a Greybeard. Where are they? Oh, they're all like meditating in here. Very spooky.
Ah,
hey, Agnir.
You've retrieved the horn of Jorgen Wimkoll.
Yes, been meaning
well
to
done.
Give you this for a little while.
You have now passed all the trials.
Ooh.
Come with me. It is time for us to recognize you formally as Dragonborn.
I think they're going
to
do some sort of chant.
The final word of unrelenting force.
Ooh. We could definitely have pushed Urgerd off the cliff with this. Become a dragon for me, my friend.
Stand between us and prepare yourself.
Oh my gosh. They're all gonna shout at me at the same time. Okay, let's see how this goes. Oh my gosh. That's a bit cultish, isn't it? One of them's got a really whispery voice.
May Ishnu, Ishmir, Tova Zebrov, Dama, Da, Rock.
Okay. Okay, guys, that's enough now. I get it.
Dovahkiin, you have tasted the voice of the Greybeards and passed through unscathed. Hrothgar
is open to you. Hey! Let's try out our shout now, guys.
Fus!
Hey, check that out. That is pretty strong. If those false one were around now, they would not have killed my dog and my worst enemy, Ilthgaard. I mean, I'm sad
your
now that she's gone. I am sad
well,
now that she's gone.
Dragonborn. Sky above, voice within.
I need to learn the shout used to defeat Alduin.
Where did you learn of that? Who have you been talking to?
Should we tell him? Let's tell him about Alduin's Wall.
The Blades, of course. They specialize in meddling in matters
these guys,
barely understand.
These guys do not get on, do they?
Knows no bounds.
You weren't going
to
help.
Not now. Not until you return to the path of wisdom.
He's not going to help us. What's that noise? Somebody is whispering to me. Did you hear that?
Forgive me, I was intemperate. I allowed my emotions to cloud my judgment. Master Einarth reminded
he
me.
He got done. He got told off.
Decision whether or not
he was a naughty greybeard.
Is not mine to make.
So you can teach me?
I cannot teach it to you because I do not know it.
Why didn't you just say that?
It is called Dragonrend, but its words of power are unknown to us. Only Parthenax, the master of our order, can answer that question.
It's a good little twist coming.
If he so chooses.
I need to speak to him.
You weren't ready. You still aren't ready. But, thanks to the Blades, you now have questions that only Parthenax can answer.
So we can go and meet him.
I will show you how to...
Lock.
I got you.
Here we go. We're learning the clear sky shots. We're learning all three. Look at that. All three of them have been learned. Summer clear skies.
This is your final gift from us, Dragonborn. Use it well.
Use it well. Is he going to do his little... There we go. Okay, so now we need to change to that shout. Clear skies. Clear the fog. The fog? The fog. But only for a time. Okay, let's give it a go, guys. Ooh, don't go too close to it. It hurts you. No. That did not work.
Look!
Look at that! Hey, it's let us go through. The more I play, the more I feel sad that Uthgaard is dead. I don't know where her body is, and she was carrying things for me. So, that's not great. Why am I being hurt? Something's hurting me. Can I see that again? There we go, there we go. So the mist actually hurts. You have to use this just to get through. Look at this place. Look how high up we are. I think this is basically the most high up point of the map, the throat of the world. Super high. This little ram's coming with me for the journey. Sorry, Ram. So we're heading up here to go meet the leader of the Greybeards. Sounds like he's going to be a pretty old guy. I know things that I'm not telling you. Throat of the World. Here we go. The highest point of Skyrim, where the home of... Oh my gosh, guys, a dragon! An old Grand dragon. Yodok.
Greetings, Wundunik.
So, Parthenax is actually a dragon. That was a little twist of the tale.
What brings you to my Strunmach, my mountain?
We use Dragonborn Farm. I wasn't expecting you to be a dragon.
I am as my father Akatosh made me, as are you, Dovahkiin.
Dovahkiin.
Tell
me, Dragonborn.
Why do you come here, Volan? Why do you intrude on my meditation?
Because we need a shout.
Drem. Patience. There are formalities which must be observed at the first meeting of two of the Dove.
Do I have to fight him?
By long tradition, the elder speaks first. Hear my thum. Feel it in your bones. Match it if you are Dovahkiin.
Why is it going all wavy and crazy up here?
Why do you intrude here if not for Tinvark?
Oh, look, he's just given us a word of power. I don't know what word it is. Fire breath. Oh, thank you. A little gift for us. Wow. He's kind. He's teaching us things. Let's equip our new shout, which is fire breath. Oh, we can't. We can't use it yet. I thought he gave us our thing, though.
Now,
use your fire breath on him. This guy likes pain.
Greet me, not as elf, but as Dova.
If you really want me to. There we go. It did nothing to him. That's how strong this guy is.
Rostmul, the dragon blood runs strong in you. It is long since I had the pleasure of speech with one of my own kind.
Look how old he is. Look at his poor little wings.
So,
oh gosh.
You
oh gosh.
Your way
he's right in our face.
Hey. Easy task for
hey,
a
Father
Jor, mortal. Even for one of Dova's source, dragon blood.
It looks so funny, those clothes.
What would you ask of me?
I mean, one, to get your smelly breath out of our face, but two, teach us dragon rent.
I have expected you, Proda. You would not come all this way for Tinvark with an old Dova. No. You seek your
weapon against
Alduin.
Yes, that's exactly why we are here. The Dragobius didn't want me to come at all. Like, I'm gonna go grass on them. Yeah, but you know it or what?
Croesus, sorrowfully, no. It cannot be known to me.
What? So you can't help us?
Your kind, Jor, mortals, created it as a weapon against the Dove, the dragon.
So
our
he can't teach us.
Our minds cannot even comprehend.
So who created it? I know mankind did, but how can we learn it?
Drem, all in good time.
We have to go back
first,
in time.
A question for you. Why do you want to learn this thum?
To defeat Alduin.
Yes, Alduin, Zembach. The elder
his
brother,
elder brother,
gifted, grasping, and troublesome, as is so often the case with firstborn.
I'm a firstborn. So
but
is Ali, actually. We both have a little brother.
Why must you stop Alduin?
Because I am the Dragonborn. Only the Dragonborn can stop him.
True, but Kosteed, prophecy, tells what may be, not what should be.
Okay.
Kosteed Salo Ak. Just because you can do a thing does not always mean you should.
That is good advice for everything, including if you want to say something mean.
Do you have no better reason for acting than destiny? Are you nothing but a plaything of Dez, of fate?
Yeah, but we also like this world. Let's go for the badass approach. I don't believe in destiny, but I
and
will
so
stop him.
Perhaps your destiny will be fulfilled. Who can say?
Right, how can we learn Dragon Man then?
Des Mortmahus. Even to the Dove who ride the currents of time, destiny is elusive. Alduin believes that he will prevail, with good reason, Rakmul. And he is no fool, Nime. Rinnik Gutnol, far from it. He began as the wisest and most far-seeing of us all.
So he...
But you have indulged my weakness for speech long enough. Krosis, now I will answer your question. Do you know why I live here, at the peak of the Monaven, what you name Throat of the World?
Why is he just swaying constantly? I don't know, you like mountains?
True, but few now remember that this was the very spot where Alduin was defeated by the ancient tongues.
Why do you hang out here then?
Varucht Unslad. Perhaps none but me now remember how he was defeated.
Using the dragon rend?
Yes and no. Viknus Nikaron. Alduin was not truly defeated either. If he was, you would not be here today seeking to defeat
I feel
him.
Like we definitely need to step back. I'm way too close to this guy's face.
The lords of those days used the dragon rend shout to cripple Alduin. But this was not enough. Ok Mulag Unslad. It was the Kel, the Elder Scroll. They used it to.
So we need to get an Elder Scroll.
Cast him adrift on the currents of time.
It clearly didn't work last time.
How to explain in your tongue? It is an artifact from outside time. It does not exist, but it has always existed.
It's kind of like Schrodinger's cat.
They are fragments of creation. The Kele, Elder Scrolls, as you name them, they have often been used for prophecy. Yes, your prophecy comes from an Elder Scroll.
I like it when they say the name of the game.
But this is only a small part of their power. Zophar Suryeh. Not intentionally. Some hoped he would be gone forever. Forever lost. Meye. I knew better. Tidbo Amativ. Time flows ever onward. One day, he would surface.
Which he has done now. So it's not a very good idea
Which
to hide him in time, because he'll always come
here.
Back out.
For thousands of mortal years, I have waited. I knew where he would emerge, but not when.
Well, you kind of missed him then, because he's already out and about.
Tid Krent.
You've seen him.
Time was shattered here because of what the ancient Nords did to Alduin. If you brought that Kel, that Elder Scroll, back here to the Tid Achran, the Time Wound...
I like their language, Tid Achran.
...with the Elder Scroll that was used to break time, you may be able to cast yourself back to the other end of the break. You could learn Dragonrend. From those who created it.
That's a clever idea. But we're still kind of left with...
Krosis.
Where do we put him?
I know little of what has passed below in the long years I have lived here. You are likely better informed than I.
Where would it be?
Trust your instincts, Dovahkiin. Your blood will show you the way.
So we should ask the Greybeards and we should ask the Blades and see if they can help us find this Elder Scroll.
Greetings.
And we finally get out of his face. I think he hangs out on this rock, perhaps. How awesome. We like this guy. He is a cool dragon. But for now, let's go back and ask the Greybeards first, since they're right here. I feel like this guy is not going to help me, though. He doesn't like fighting.
He believes it is necessary for you to learn this. We will bow to his wisdom.
Thanks.
I need the Elder Scroll. We have never concerned ourselves with the scrolls. The gods themselves would rightly fear to tamper with such things. As for where to find it, such blasphemies have always been the stock and trade of the mages of Winterhold.
They may clearly don't like those too much.
About the Elder Scroll you seek.
So we need to go to the College of Winterhold.
Sky, guard you.
Okay, let's head back out of here. So, the College of Winterhold is actually, when I play Live Another Life on PC, that's where I tend to start, in Winterhold College. It's obviously like super far north, super cold. So let's journey to the College of Winterhold. So I've decided to go to Markarth first. One, because we're gonna buy another dog when that opens. But two, because we need to get another follower. So we're gonna see if there's one in Markarth that we can use. So this is what Markarth looked like. I think it's actually, it was originally built by the dwarves. So it's pretty cool looking. But I think we're gonna just hire like a mercenary. Which means, like Earthgird, we need to head to a pub. So, let's find the local drinking hall and get ourselves a new companion. Where is a mercenary? This guy looks very mercenary.
I'm what you'd call a soldier of...
That's
a fair price. My blade is yours.
Woo! And he's got like a little ram on his shoulder, which is pretty cool. So, we've got ourselves a new mercenary. Let's go get ourselves a new dog, and then let's head all the way to the College of Winterhold.
Sorry. You already have an animal with you.
What do you mean? What, so I can't have a horse and a dog at the same time?
You look like you might be sick.
What? Oh, that sucks. You've got to pick between a horse and a dog.
You need a reliable horse in the reach.
Oh, I wanted both. I've actually got to pick up another stray dog along the way. Ooh, hello. Right. Please, can you take us to
Winterhold? Where do you want to go?
The College of Winterhold. There we go. 50 gold. It's expensive to head there. So this is Winterhold. As you can see, super cold. Also pretty rundown. And this is the College of Winterhold. I don't know if they're going to actually just let me walk in there.
Cross the bridge at your own peril. The way is dangerous and the gate will not open. You shall not gain entry.
Wow, that's harsh.
Oh. Forgive me. Most who arrive here do so because they are... This is the College of Winterhold.
May I enter?
Perhaps. But what is it you expect to find within?
I need to ask about the Elder Scrolls.
Do you? It is true there are some here who have spent years studying the accumulated knowledge of the scrolls.
Well, then I need
But
them.
What you seek does not come easily and can destroy those without a strong will. It would seem that the College has what you seek. The question now is, what can you offer the College?
I am a great student.
Not just anyone is allowed inside. Those wishing to enter must show some degree of skill with magic.
I know some magic.
A small test, if you will.
Okay. I think we both know that I'm going to succeed here.
No, I'm afraid I don't know anything of the sort.
Dumb. I'll take your test.
Excellent. The fear spell has saved the life of many an illusion mage. If you could cast it on the seal here on the ground, that would prove your skill.
Okay. Pow!
Well done indeed.
Yeah.
I think you'll be a superb addition to the College.
Well, you were so keen on us 5 minutes ago.
I'll lead you across the bridge. Once you're inside, you'll want to speak with Mirabel Irvine, our master wizard. Please, follow me.
I actually really like this storyline as well, and I would love to do the kind of... You become the Archmage of Winterhold, basically, and the Thalmor are involved in it, and it's super fun. But we are doing our main quest line, so we are just here to learn about the Elder Scrolls. So So this is what it looks like in the College of Winterhold. This is the one that I mentioned. There's a really cool mod for that basically turns it into Harry Potter. If you're playing on PC, it's called the Immersive College of Winterhold. And I would 100% recommend it because it adds so much content to this place. But we are here to speak to the orc that works in the library and ask him about the Elder Scrolls.
You are now in the Arcanium, of which I am in charge.
Wow, midi.
It might as well be my own little plane of oblivion.
Okay, but can you just tell disrupt us about the Elder Scroll, please?
And I will have you torn apart by angry Atronach.
Wow, dude,
now,
no need for
this. You require assistance.
Yes. Please, can you tell us about the Elder Scroll?
And what do you plan to do with it? Do you even know what you're asking about? Or are you just someone's errand girl?
Fam, I will burn you. Of course I do.
You think that even if I did have one here, I would let you see it? It would be kept under the highest security. The greatest thief in the world wouldn't be able to lay a finger on it.
Oh, well, what about the Dragonborn?
What about? Wait. Are you? Were you the one the Greybeards were calling?
Yes, I am.
I'll bring everything we have on them. But it's not much.
He changed his tune as well.
So don't get your hopes up. It's mostly lies, leavened with rumor and conjecture.
Okay. Well, show us what you've got.
All right, then.
The Rise and Fall of the Blades. I feel like that's there for a reason. Oh, do you think he's got like a little super secret? Oh, I thought he had a super secret passageway. We can steal from his bookcase.
Here you go. Try not to spill anything on them.
On what? Oh, look, there's my new follower. Vostag. Come on, dude, give us what you've got.
I don't want to see you treating any of these books poorly. Are we clear?
He just whipped out some bread from his pocket. Has he given us some
hundreds
bread?
Of years.
Okay, so apparently this is quite a common glitch that the game has.
I don't
want
to see you treating any of these
But you can go
poorly.
To the person. I just googled it. You can go to the person that you need to speak to directly. And he is on a northern iceberg. So, let's go and try and find him. It's kind of annoying. It's kind of an annoying way to do things, but I guess it can't be helped. So, we are traveling... Oh, we are drowning. We are traveling north of where the College of Winterhold is. There it is, perched precariously on the edge of a cliff. We need to go north of it. And we're kind of using our thoom again to sort of speed us forward a little bit. Just say that. I found it! Oh my gosh! Is this it? Oh my gosh, that took me so long to find! That took me so long to find! But we got there in the end. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh, it's not fighting me. It's not fighting me. Oh gosh, he's fighting it though. Maybe that's a different place. I thought that was the right place. What? Oh gosh! Oh man, they are not happy that we went in there. Oh my gosh. That is a weird place. Oh my gosh. We've actually found it this time. Septimus Singer's Outpost. Okay, apparently this is where that quest would have led you if we didn't get the glitch. Pretty. It's pretty here. What is this place? Here's this guy. Hello.
Dig, Dwemer in the beyond. I'll know you're lost on no-
Oh, this guy seems a bit loopy though.
The bane of Kagranak and Degothur.
And he's got like a big dwarven thing in here as well.
Is to know the Elder Scroll.
He knows about the Elder Scroll though, guys. At least we're on the right path.
Ring about the opening.
You have an Elder Scroll.
I have seen enough to know their fabric. The warp of air, the weft of time.
Okay, a simple yes would have, or a simple no would have done. A simple no. So where is it?
Here. In the depths of Black Reach, one yet lies.
So we have to go into Black Reach.
Have you heard of Black Reach? Cast upon where Drimmer City slept, the yearning spire hidden learnings kept.
Okay, where is Black Reach then?
Under deep, below the dark.
The hidden keep. Tower Mazark. Oh, you're such a poet! What does he mean?
Find Mazark and its sky dome. The machinations there will read the scroll and lay the lore upon the cube.
Okay.
Trust Septimus. He knows.
You give me no reasons to trust you because you're a bit crazy. Okay. So we've kicked off the next section. We just need to transcribe this lexicon, and I think we need to go to Blackreach for that. But I am going to do that in the next episode because this took. Shh! Dude, shush! Stop! Dude, stop ruining my outro! Shh! Shush, dude, shush! Okay, so we're going to leave it there for today. So in the next episode, we'll be going into Blackreach and recovering the Elder Scroll, which we can then use to hopefully banish Alduin, hopefully forever, and take him on in a fight as well. If you enjoyed this episode, please leave it a thumbs up. I'm having so much fun recording Skyrim for you guys. I honestly never thought this was a game I was gonna get to do on my YouTube channel because I didn't think they would ever remake it, and I had so much fun playing it that I was desperate to give it another go. I'm glad you guys are enjoying this as much as I am. Anyway guys, that's it for now. So I shall see you in the next episode. Bye.